good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen.
Ooh, hello. I am in. Hello.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for sticking around and joining us for the Riviera Film Festival. I have here with me a young lady called Laura Harvey, and it's all fantastic. And she is a makeup and prop maker, so please give her a big round of applause. That's done. Thank you very much. So, Laura, what inspired you to get into makeup for film?
I went to university to study art, a little bit more different to what I do now, a bit more fine art, sort of style stuff, but I realised after university that I'm not very good at making pretty things. Every time I tried to make something that was pretty, it would just turn out a little bit wrong.
Right,
yeah.
Okay.
So then, using that, once I realised that, I thought, why don't I use that and try and make things that aren't going wrong. And so that's when I started getting into makeup effects, wounds, gore, that sort of thing. And now I work more in prop making. That's my speciality shop at the moment. But it goes across all sorts of disciplines. It's not just the horror stuff now. I do stuff for charity events, shop windows, and things like that. Yeah.
Fantastic. So you might have seen Laura's stand, it's just around there, it's the stand with all the fingers and the eyeballs. They're quite fantastic, if not a little bit terrifying. So they're great to look at. No, you're more than welcome. I've seen that the young gentleman at the front here has a broken nose.
Yeah.
I was a little nervous, I thought they'd had a punch, but that's a bit of makeup. Now, any particular pieces that you've worked on that you've been really, really proud of, something that's that made you go, yeah, this is why I'm doing this?
I think most of the time when the director comes to me with a really vivid idea of what they want. That's my joy. I like trying to create what they've got in their head so they actually get to see it on screen. And I think one of my favourite ones was doing a blood effect, which is actually it was quite horrible. It was a slit throat, which is actually, it's really simple to do, but it's only a one-shot take. So if it goes wrong, we'll have to take all of it off again and redo it. But we managed to get the first shot. Not in there, but underneath the camera with this little pump, just pumping up blood. So it's
goodness.
Yeah, so that was a lot of fun. But I've had quite a lot of challenging things, but I don't think I've ever said no to a project yet.
Good. So you're following an acting standpoint, that's good. Now, where do you see yourself in the future with this kind of work? What is something that you'd really like to build up to be able to do?
Well, recently I've been thinking about, especially around the tour day, people are on a low budget, and it is really difficult. And a lot of the times you can only afford the material costs and my time. You know, I try and do the best deal I can. But I've been thinking about making a generic line of props which people use quite often and then being available to rent out. So rather than paying on a commission basis to get something made where you're looking at £300-£400, it would then be a case of paying about £50 to take it for the day, get all your shots in, and then just come back to me.
Oh,
so that's
sort
of the hope for the future, if you like, to make it a bit easier for everyone.
Well, that's I bet half the directors in the room are suddenly there is a printer. Now, if anybody wants to find out any more information about you, is that overall on your desk?
Yeah, just come over to me and do a few more demonstrations this afternoon. Just maybe a bullet wound on Lee over there. just messing up a bit throughout the day. I've got business cards with my website and Facebook.
Fantastic. Now, if we were able for next year's film festival, would you be interested in doing a commission for us?
Yes.
Right. Lovely. Cheers, Laura. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Pleasure to have met you.
Thank you very much.
Laura. Thank you.